All right, 21:54. Let's have a look. Zulu shell. Let's see if the process is actually running. In the meanwhile, and GPT agent is running, so it was able to start in forcing mode. You'll get a lot of ABC denials now, or could be, since we're auditing a lot of stuff. Let's just have a look at GPT agent. Take my time. Yeah, it seems to be a leak. It's read writing. Cisco success was yes. So I guess that wasn't strictly needed. Okay, now let's, it's 21:57, let's just pause, tweak. So far, so good. Okay, 21:57. Meanwhile, I'll have a look and see if it's running. And they're both running. But we don't have any significant ABC denials, so we're set. This is actually working in a forcing mode. Nice. So far, so good. Let's just clear and see. Git modules, ls, git add my GPT TE, my GPT FC. We don't need the interface file because I haven't added anything to that. Git commit. So, initial policy for SC daemon GPT BCSC wrapper support, I suppose, and then get push that. Look, git show. This is basically the policy that we added. It's a bit of a hack, but then again, it's not that bad. You know, at least we have some stuff there. And actually the next stage would be to confine Matt. Yeah, that's the next stage there. Yep. I'll put that there. I'll put air seat in here. Going on, it might be might actually be accident related, although I doubt it. Oh, accident might will be to remove the silent stuff. Not sure why I can't connect to a Freenode. Is it getting packeted again? Or am I just... picking a wrong... Looks like it's getting packeted again. Now if you look at my Mud RC Nano, see that it's set up to decrypt my GPG passwords file here, so GPG will need to do some shit there. Needs to be able to read generic files. That's pretty obvious. It wants to read the signature, which probably should probably just be generic. And then it basically runs some commands here, which is we probably want to confine PGP ERET, although yeah, I suppose. So yeah, that's going to take a little while to get that right. Just why isn't it connecting? disconnecting. So we're back in business. Now we don't have to necessarily restart again and stuff. So we need to just think about our MUT policy here. Basically, we'll wanna, first let's just, oh, I'm already there in Git here. So RPM pre-release MUT, that's that. So we wanna start by zero, start at square zero. Nano, let's, or actually just touch, let's. I'm going to do MUT the same way as I did links and newsletter. Now, actually, let's just cp newsletter te. Exec file. Let's just use a bit mat. Then we have some mat home content for sure. Mat home to and this is for a bunch of files. I'm just going to remove the comments, I don't feel like them. And then we have the MUT roles. And that'll take care of the MUT. And there's actually also MUT temp files. So I'll just add those as well. Actually, I don't know if this is user. User. Okay. I'm not sure if that actually exists. Okay, cp newsletter if to met if. If that's just to find a RPM query info mat and copy over a description, a text, notes, mail user agent. And then just change this. That'll be fine. Mets. And it's met exactly. Met humpty. And met dumpty. And then met roles. And then determine whether specified user runs MUT with a domain transition. pretty much the same. The policy, we can remove all this shit for now, except this one here. Can be removed as well, and mert fc, and we have user bin mert contacts system new object r mert exec t. That's set up. Now we need to think about our mert files. LSOC grab mert. These are some thingies. And I'll probably wanna wonder it extracts mud, so it's just reading it to stand it out, so it's probably just reading so I'm just going to take care of mud cache let's add some stuff here. Home dir mud cache, this needs to be created. If it's not there, it's a single file. Gen context system u object r mert d. And similar for certificates, and similar for mert RC, but we don't want it writing to mert RC. So I'll just do this one for mert passwords. Actually, I'm not gonna do this one. I hope it's just reading it. But then again, then I don't need to do this one either. Let's just keep it as simple as possible. So, mert cache and mert certificates. Let's go to our interface file and add at least the transitions there. User, dom, user, home, dir, file, trans, and then mert t. And then it's mert home t, and then it's a file, and we need to do one per line, so So met cash and the one with met certificate, All right, and then just basically add a line here that allows Mets to write those files, manage those files. T and then file manage file curves. That should take care of that stuff. So at least we have that settled. Yeah, and then we need to allow it. But I need to look that up first. Nano user share Linux eval include system user domain interface user dom. Well, I'll be damned. Include user domain. And then search for a user dom read user content files. And this sucks, this sucks. Generic No, this is not gonna happen. I'm going to have to hack around that. Wanted to be able to read generic user home content files. I'm not going to I wanted to be able to do that. Okay, let's nano my user domain key. My unconfined user, I'm sorry. And let's just copy this one over. Newsletter role, and we have a mid role. store from the user bin met. Okay, now let's I guess let's try it out in permissive mode. Setup force 0, sudo setup force 0, run it. Let's open this one. And I'll just I'll search user abc as a Linux and then ts decent, I suppose. Now you might want to sudo that, and you might want to left that as well, because there's probably going to be some ABC denials there. Yeah. So, we need to take care of the transitions first. That's always the first thing you do. Take care of your transitions. So what's being executed? What's being executed? Basically, at this point, only GPT agent is executed. So we want to actually have a domain transition there. Nano user share as in Linux devel include contrib. We want a GPT agent run if possible. And that's obviously not possible. So we'll have to hack around that as well. A lot of hacks. Optional policy. Gen require. Types. GPT agent. GPT agent exact T, and then we'll want to dom trans pattern. We don't want it to be able to read the GPT secret files. GPT, what is it? S1 mark T. GPT agent exact and GPT agent T. And then we also want to allow the mets allow or actually role met roles type. Want to allow the met roles the GPT agent domain. That'll take care of that bit, I suppose. they don't think of that, so that. We need to take out the temp file, but we'll wait with that. Alright, so the time is now 22:25. Okay, and now it wants to execute GPG. So we have the same shit all over again. But because if I go up, it was GPG agent, wasn't it? Or was I just stupid? No, actually, I was just stupid. I didn't read right. I didn't read it right. I did a mistake. I did a boo-boo. It happens. It happens. Let's have a look again. See if I can do. On the other hand, I might need that. I'll try this. I'll try this. What is it? World domain. World domain. So, role is mid roles, and domain is see if this works. Yeah, I might need that. For pin entry and stuff like that. Okay, time is 22:30. Let's just bust it. See, now it's not prompting for the pin because it's still in the cache. this looks much cleaner. Let's copy this over. Let's use a temp t file and use a home t. Ouch, that looks nasty. Let's just grab user. Bless it. Wanna see what's going on there. Then it's connecting to use a temp t, that's PKS, yes. Wonder what creates that. And then we have write mid cache. What the hell? Oh, I didn't restore on that. I just wonder what created that PKCS file. I guess I just need to allow that. So basically, you have this key ring created, and Mutt uses that to connect to something, to something, something PKCS related. It'll take care of that that stuff. But yeah, that ship just needs to be taken care of. So did I copy this stuff? Let's just copy it again. Oh yeah, I need to look that up. System user domain. And then user dom stream connect. That's not gonna fly for me. That's not gonna do cut it for me. I'm gonna manually take care of that. So that's going to be a hack. Optional policy. It's not really optional, but we can. require type user temp t, and then I'll just use a stream connect pattern, stream connect pattern. User temp t, user temp t, and then it's in this case the calling user domain, which is variable free. That's a little bit cleaner. Okay, let's just paste this shit in here. Okay, let's just go from the top, login, send syslog, syslog message. We have a out use and a switch. Out use and a switch. And what's exactly for out? I would need to look that up to make it clean. I'll just remove the stuff that I know that's not appropriate. That's taken care of. This, the Unix datagram socket's probably taken care of as well. These are the things. This one is also most likely taken care of. Then the remainder, I need to just look that up. So let's just look that up. Master tree policy modules, and then system, and then the auth login module, and then the, all the way below should be some out and a switch related rules and a switch domain, some rules, manage key perms, outread passwords, so the password file. And DNS, oh yeah, and then let's just take care of outread password first. That can be removed. Then have a look at some other stuff. Files, list file, etc files. DNS name resolve sysnet. Because that also adds a bunch of rules. It sysnet with config, here you have it. So yeah, TCP UDP socket, and so these can take, get rid of these. Generic certs, this should probably be it. So yeah, by just calling that NS out of that out user NS switch, you can remove a bunch of rules there. And it's, connecting to the POP port, let's take care of that. Core net TCP connect. pop or we have a kernel. Kernel read system state, that's for the probably for the shell. It's running a shell to run the PGP stuff in, I guess. So let's just copy this O on top. And here we have the core command exec shell. So I'll just add that here. Core command exec shell. That takes care of that, and then we have this stuff in temp, and then we have dev read rand. Dev read, which might actually also be allowed with the out using that switch, but this I'll just add it. And then we have a user DOM use inherited user terminals. And this is just for reading mail. This is not for writing encrypted emails yet. Now this stuff here needs to go up. And we need to actually figure this one out. What's it writing? Grab. Less. It's probably creating an oh. It's probably creating a directory with a file in there. Doing anything. But it's creating a mud there. And where's the file? Yeah, it's creating a file in the mud there. Let's just assume that. So, do the following. Allow scribe one merge t merge temp t there merge here perhaps. Allow scribe one merge underscore t. File verbs, and then just use a files temp file trans and we can't use a named file transition, but it's not really needed either. Anyways, that'll take care of that as well. And yeah, that's about it, I suppose. Let's just set up force one. Oh, sudo set up force one. And let's just see if it actually starts. It starts. Let's just have a look at FCNow's Flash 2046. No entries at all. Neat. Nah, okay, let's just remember and send an email to myself encrypted. How do I do that? I'm basically just... Jesus Christ. Oh, yeah, I am. Two. Subject testing error running, and we have a permission denied. Running mud, nano. It's trying to run nano. Because I use nano as my editor. So yeah. But the shitty thing is there that I'm just going to for now. Use this, audit, allow, bin t, file, check file, terms, and I'll just again require. Now I'm not sure if this actually allows it, but I guess I'll find out. Probably not. I think this will only audit allows and not actually allow it as well. Getting late. See, that doesn't work. I should just and actually I don't have to require that. Quite the mess. Okay. Hello world. Well, just I think it's no. I forgot how to do that. Let's just sign up. See if this works. Seems to work. Oh no, connect. Cannot connect to the server. Jesus. Damn it. Of course, that's in a forcing mode, so. But at least the bin entry works. So this is limit SMTP port. So let's copy this over. And coordinate SMTP port. I don't have to restart it. I can just do it over. And that seems to work. Let's just see what what it's executing, but it's actually executing PTP ERAP. Try this one again. Mail. Dead. Override. Gmail. Home. Test one. Another. Hello. And now how? Let's just do help first. GPT related stuff. Pipe entry. Where's my GPT related stuff? Ah, P. Q. P. Both. Yeah. seems to actually work. Let's see what we have here. Yeah, see PGP ERAP, but I'm just allowing that to execute. So that's fine. So yeah, I guess I'm already set. Nice. So let's just edit that rule out that I'd allow. And just make a comment there. PGP ERAP and nano. So this is it. It's not half bad. But yeah, I probably forgot some shit. So I'm gonna reboot after the single time. Actually, I'm not gonna do that. I'm not going to do that. Gonna force clear. Git and merit. So yeah, in a couple hours I can find a bunch of shit, at least initially, git show, at least some initial stuff. I'm sure there's bugs here, or bugs, at least I'm sure it's incomplete and there's some nasty hacks there. I worked around some missing interfaces and stuff like that, but all in all, I achieved the goal. Mutt can't read GPG files. And Mutt is pretty confined, so if my Mutt gets compromised, then it won't be able to read my SSH or my GPG keys. It will be able to execute GPG, but yeah, it won't be able to. It'll prompt for a pin, and so the attacker won't be able to authenticate because he doesn't have my pin. And other than that, it just looks pretty clean. Hopefully, that is actually clean. Let's see. Okay. Let's just get out of here. Yeah, this is it.